Hey YouTube, what's going on? So, Bill Nye the Science Guy recently released a video attempting to debunk the pro-life movement using science. Before I begin my in-depth critique, I do want to take the time to preface this video and say that, like most of you, I grew up watching Bill Nye the Science Guy. He was a role model. He made learning science fun. So for me personally, it's sad that someone who was once a role model is now willingly and unscientifically deceiving Americans about abortion. Let's take a look at what he has to say.
Many, 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 many more hundreds of eggs are fertilized than become humans. Eggs get fertilized, and by that I mean sperm get accepted by ova a lot. But that's not all you need. You have to attach to the uterine wall, the inside of a woman's womb. But if you're going to hold that as a standard, that is to say, if you're going to say when an egg is fertilized, it's therefore has the same rights as an individual, then whom are you going to sue? Whom are you going to imprison? Every woman who's had a fertilized egg pass through her? Every guy whose sperm has fertilized an egg and then it didn't become a human? Have all these people failed you?
This could have actually been a clever point if it weren't for the fact that we have countless causes of natural occurring deaths, such as old age, sickness, cancer. A natural death can happen to any human at any stage of life in any environment, such as a hospital, a home, and yes, even in the womb. So trying to equate a miscarriage, which is natural, to abortion is like trying to equate old age, death from old age, to murder. The two are completely different things, and anyone with any ounce of common sense knows this. I mean, come on, this is so basic. It makes me want to ask Bill, where's the science guy? Any embryologist that you talk to will tell you that clearly the creation of a new embryo marks the first stage of the human journey. I was once an embryo, you were once an embryo, Bill Nye was once an embryo. And yes, these embryos are human life, and this is something I want you to understand. These embryos didn't develop into humans, they developed as humans. Now yes, women have miscarriages. Fertilized eggs pass through women. Not every fertilized egg gets to develop to the point where it's viable human life. But an embryo doesn't have to be in a hospitable environment to be human. Any good scientist knows that your environment has nothing to do with defining what species you are. And speaking of environment, there are many places around the world where newborn babies die naturally at alarmingly high rates. So according to Bill's logic, does that mean that these babies weren't human?
It's just a reflection of a deep scientific lack of understanding. And you literally, or you apparently literally don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, this is easily the most blatant and distasteful, disrespectful case of elitism we've seen all year. Are you suggesting that being pro-life and having scientific knowledge are mutually exclusive? Because there are many embryologists, there are many physicians, there are many people with a scientific background that are pro-life. And I don't mean to be disrespectful, Bill, but to put you in your place, you are a mechanical engineer. You studied mechanical engineering. The bulk of your career is in engineering. You're not an embryologist. You're not even a biologist. You're definitely not a philosopher. So according to your own logic, does this mean that you apparently literally don't know what you're talking about? I mean, it's disgusting. Literally disgusting, the amount of elitism and I-know-it-all attitude oozing from this video. For me personally, it reminds me a lot of the Dixie Chicks, who had decent careers in music and threw it all away because of political hogwash.
And so when it comes to women's rights with respect to their reproduction, I think you should leave it to women. It's really... you cannot help but notice. I mean, I'm not the first guy to observe this. You have a lot of men of European descent passing these extraordinary laws based on ignorance.
First, killing the baby inside of you is not a reproductive right. Second, there are many, many women in America and around the world who are pro-life. In fact, there are many feminist women who have made the case against abortion. Number three, I'm not of European descent. And number four, what does anyone's background, anyone's class, age, gender have to do with the merit of their opinion on abortion?
Sorry, you guys. I know it was written, or your interpretation of a book written 5,000 years ago, 50 centuries ago, makes you think that when a man and a woman have sexual intercourse, they always have a baby. That's wrong. And so to pass laws based on that belief is inconsistent with nature.
And cue the anti-religion bashing. Now, let me tell you something in case you haven't noticed yet, but I have yet to talk about God in this video. In fact, in all of my other pro-life videos, I haven't talked about God at all. Why? Because it's not even a religious issue. Liberals try to say that the only reason that people are pro-life is because of religion, but that's not true. There are many scientific and there are many philosophical reasons to be opposed to abortion. And that's why there are many atheists and there are many secular people that are also pro-life. You know, the irony of this whole thing is that this is actually more of a scientific issue. Talk to any embryologist and they will tell you that the earliest stage of human development begins at fertilization.
I mean, it's hard not to get frustrated with this, everybody. And I know nobody likes abortion, okay? But you can't tell somebody what to do.
Nobody likes murder, but you can't tell people what to do. This is the type of logic, philosophy that Bill Nye is using, and quite frankly, it's asinine. We have laws. We can tell people what to do in order to keep order and to protect the rights of other people. And laws are there to do just that, to protect the rights of those around us, to protect our rights, and to protect the rights of even the littlest and most vulnerable among us.
You wouldn't know how big a human egg was if it weren't for microscopes, if it weren't for scientists who are medical researchers looking diligently. You wouldn't know the process. You wouldn't have that shot, the famous shot or shots where the sperm are bumping up against the egg. You wouldn't have that without science. So then to claim that you know the next step when you obviously don't is trouble. Okay, let me do that again. Let me just pull back. At some point, we have to respect the facts.
Yes. You are absolutely right. Facts matter and we have to use facts. And that's why many pro-lifers, if not the majority of pro-lifers, understand scientific literature. They understand the earliest forms of human development. And that's why we take the opinions and the stances that we do. We're not uninformed or uneducated as you and many other liberals are trying to suggest. And let me say something for the record. When your video, Bill, went viral, a lot of these headlines were saying, Bill Nye slams abortion using science. That sort of revealed to me that liberals and atheists have sort of turned science into a god. And the problem with that is that science really doesn't tell us anything. Science basically is an observation of how the world works. And science, in case you haven't remembered, is all about questioning things. Science can change. Scientists once, for example, scientists once thought that the world was flat. It's obviously not flat. So the science of today could very well be the mythology of tomorrow. And also, facts and scientific knowledge really don't do that much on their own. And basically, what I'm trying to say is that knowledge, scientific knowledge, is just one half of the equation. You also have to have understanding. And when you have the two of them together, I think that's when you're able to form a logical and well-grounded opinion in something. For example, you can have the scientific knowledge, the scientific facts that salt, for example, has dehydrating properties. Salt basically will dehydrate anything. We put it on meat. It dries things up, right? And so if you tell that to someone, and if you tell someone that fact, they might think, oh, I have to avoid salt at all costs. It could kill me. It could be deadly. It could be unhealthy. But the reality is, and this is where understanding comes in, is that our body also needs electrolytes. Athletes need electrolytes to be able to stay hydrated. And of course, salt is very rich in electrolytes. It's a source for that. So scientific facts alone They're really not that impressive. You also have to have understanding, and when the two are together, I think that's when you can form really powerful opinions. But anyways, all of that to say that Bill's video was not science. It certainly wasn't philosophy. In my opinion, all it was rhetoric and propaganda to promote his liberal agenda. And you know what? I hope that you share this video with your friends, because here's the thing. A lot of people have been sharing the Bill Nye video, and people who are sort of on the fence about abortion, they might think it's okay because they might think it's rooted in scientific fact, whatever that is, that abortion isn't all that bad, and it's time that we get more alternative voices out there to counter what liberals and the secular world is trying to push down our throats. But those are just my thoughts, and I would love to hear yours in the comments below. Please feel free to subscribe, like me on Facebook, and I will see you soon.